One. Hi again, everyone, and welcome to this edition of First Person, sponsored by the Precision Strip Company in Minster, Ohio. A great place to work. We talk about them all the time to either start a career or finish one. They're always looking for good people, and they might be looking for you. So check them out, give them a call, stop by, or check them online with the address that's scrolling across the bottom of First Person here. Again, the Precision Strip Company in Minster, Ohio, sponsors of First Person on Press Pros. Talking high school bowling today with a young man that I'm anxious to meet and talk to. He's the reigning champion in Division I bowling in the state of Ohio, Ohio High School Athletic Association bowling, Drew Sachs from Vandalia Butler. Congratulations on the championship, and thanks for taking the time to talk with us.
Thank you, and thanks for having me.
You're absolutely welcome. I'm excited about this because I want to know more about specifically how you've gotten to be what you've done. I know you had a 297 here a few weeks ago. I wish I'd have seen that because that's getting up there. But tell me a little bit about the championship and winning that last year and what that meant to you.
So going into it, we had a pretty good team, and we're all just bowling together, having a good time. I always tend to bowl my best when I'm having a good time. I'm comfortable with the people I like, and we're having a good time. When I was bowling, you know, I threw the ball good, and when I found out I won, it was the most amazing feeling in the world. Like, when I felt like I accomplished something very few people could, and it was great.
It's also, I think, one of the sports, and I've always said this about bowling and golf, you got to be good, but you got to be
lucky.
You got to be lucky too, and to combine those two, especially when the stakes are that high, is pretty special.
It's definitely pretty tough.
Pretty special. Everybody's got a story about how they got started in bowling. I hear kids say, I started when I was 2, when I was 4. I had my first 100 game when I was 5, and my first 200 when I was 8 or 10. Tell me a little bit about your story.
Yeah, well, Mom and Dad both bowled in college, so me and my three older siblings, we grew up bowling in the bowling alley. Every weekend, we were in a bowling alley doing something, watching someone bowl. And so I didn't really get into it until when I got a little older. But once it came around 7th, 8th grade, freshman year, I really just got the itch for it and just loved the game.
How has it gotten so popular in high school? Because I go everywhere. We are up in the MAC quite a bit in Coldwater and St. Henry and Versailles and areas like that. We see some great bowlers up there. And, I mean, they live, breathe, and die the sport of bowling. Has it been that way for you?
Oh, yeah, 100%. Me and my friends, we spend our lives in a bowling alley. It's just favorite place to be.
My friend Jerry Snodgrass, who's the commissioner of the OHSAA, calls it a different culture, another level of competitive athlete. What's he mean by that?
I think it means in other sports you have, you know, it's who's the biggest, who's the strongest, who's the fastest, and all that. Bowling is a lot of mental game, and you have to keep your mind and everything intact the whole time you're competing, because if you let it slip, you can just have one of the worst performances you can.
You know, the other thing about bowling is it's not just as simple as hitting the pins between the 1-3 or the 1-2 if you're a left-hander. It's all the different conditions, the adjustments you have to make to lanes and oil and patterns. Why is that?
There's a ton of different variables out there, like different lane surfaces, like some of the old school wood that everybody grew up with.
Some are synthetic.
Synthetic, different oils, you know, some that a little slicker than others, and then they change the oil pattern, which however many feet of oil there is out there.
You go to a school that has a tremendous legacy in competition here. I mean, I go back to Coach Zawatsky when he won all those basketball games here. Steve Pelfrey was so successful in football. Trent Dues has a great 20-year legacy in winning baseball here. How does bowling fit in with the traditions and the legacy of competition and championships at Vandalia Butler?
Yeah, bowling the last 3 or 4 years has really gotten good here at Butler. We've won the conference the last 3 years. The last 2 years, and we're probably gonna win it this year. And we've made it to state the last 2 years. We finished 5th and 6th as a team, and it's been a good ride.
But does it get the respect and the appreciation from the other sports in proportion to football?
It does. It really does. The people like Principal Luby and the athletic director Jordan. Everybody respects us. Everybody treats us as we're another sport out there. All the other athletes have nothing but respect for us.
Drew Sachs, the reigning state champion in Division I bowling from Vandalia Butler, is our guest today. Let me ask you about where you go next with bowling. You graduate this year. What lies ahead for you in bowling?
I'm actually going to the Lindenwood University. It's out in St. Charles, Missouri, and they have a pretty good bowling team. I'm going there to major in finance. So.
In finance?
Finance, yeah.
I've got to ask you this, too. Most kids have somebody they grew up watching or emulating or imitating, wanting to be like. Who's your PBA guy?
My PBA guy? I'm very big old school guy, so Pete Weber is my guy. Yeah.
Now, you got the hair going on. You got the style thing going on. I would have thought maybe you would have gone back to like a Norm Duke or Gubby Troop. Yep. Yeah, some guys like that.
Yeah.
When you watch those guys, what do you see from a Parker Bone or a Dick Weber or somebody like that? What do you see in those guys that you don't have as a bowler?
Just the legacy. I mean, those guys are some of the greatest bowlers of all time. And I mean, bowling was different back in the day. I mean, they were bigger than football stars. They were bigger than baseball players. So.
Don Carter.
Yeah.
Don Carter.
They were very big names.
Dick Weber, Pete Weber, all those guys like that. When you think about what they've accomplished, I read recently that Norm Duke rolled three consecutive 300 games in competition.
Yeah.
And 60 straight strikes. How hard is that?
It's unbelievable. I mean, 60 strikes in a row is a lot. My best is 30, so.
30 strikes in a row.
30 strikes in a row, yeah.
And how old were you when you did that?
I was 17 still. It was in March of last year, so.
When you bowl down here, I'm sure you get great crowds, and it's the atmosphere and the environment is pretty special. It's pretty exciting. I can see why you'd like that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And, you know, the state tournament starts here in what, a couple weeks?
Yeah, sectionals in 2 weeks, I think, so.
What kind of pressure is that compared to the other sports?
That's kind of similar in a way, but I think since it's not all individual to start, it's all team at the beginning, so it's really just trying to get the team as far as you can. And we have really good team chemistry.
And do you ever get the feeling how claustrophobic it is because those lanes are just packed with people?
Packed.
It is, and they're right on top of it.
Yeah, I don't know. I enjoy it. I mean, bowling, everything about bowling, I love. It's my favorite thing to do. I'm in a bowling alley 80% of my time. So.
Four 300 games in competition to his credit so far. He's 17 years old, rolled a 297 here about a month ago. I'm sorry I missed that.
That's all right.
But it's been fun to sit here and talk with you.
Yes,
congratulations.
Thank
to you. And best of luck throughout the year and going to Lindenwood and everything that's ahead of you.
Sir, thank you very much.
It was worth the wait. All right, buddy. That wraps up this week's edition of First Person, again sponsored by our friends at Precision Strip up in Minster. Give them a call. They could be looking for you. A great place to work to start or finish your career. Give them a call at Precision Strip. For our guests this week and the sponsors, thanks for your support of what we do every week on PressProsMagazine.com. We'll see you again next time with another edition of First Person.